Alright, so this is the Punisher review. Thomas Jane is the Punisher. Frank Castle, very fucking badass movie. It is 124 minutes long. That is 2 hours and 4 minutes for anyone that doesn't know. It is also John Travolta, who plays as Howard Saint. He is the leader of the Saints, not to be confused with the Saints Row video game. Now, so basically Howard, or not Howard, Frank Castle, he is a big, very, a very experienced, very badass dude who's in the military. He's works undercover in drug dealing things. He speaks seven different languages. So basically, one of Howard Saint's sons is meeting along with Mick, and Mick is like, "Oh yeah, this guy's awesome. He's one of the best." And then one of Howard Saint's sons gets killed when they're doing a drug bust. So Howard tells his wife, and his wife's like, "I want you to kill his family, all of them." So they're at in Puerto Rico having a family reunion. His dad's there and everything. His dad coincid or okay, so basically they all the guys come and they're like, they all just fucking just shotgun, just AKs. Just like kill the whole fucking family, aunts, uncles, cousins, just family, friends, so many people. And then, coincidentally, right beforehand, his Frank's dad was showing him his new gun collection. Not his new gun collection, but he upgraded them, fixed them all up, and everything. ...1911 guns. So he goes and they hear a bunch of gunshots, and his dad ends up getting not making it. Fucking so Frank's fighting off all these guys. He sees his wife and son run away, but beforehand, his son was he was talking to his son, saying, you know, his son's like, "Why are we moving again, Dad?" And his son's like, or no, Frank was said, "Well, so it can be more safe." He's like, "Okay, all right, but you," he's like, "This is the last time we'll move." He's like, "You said that last time." And but when his son and him and his wife and everyone are going to Puerto Rico and stuff, having a family reunion, they're all just fucking just having a good time and stuff. So when this assault happens and just all the family members get killed, the wife and son are on a jeep, and there's a jeep chase, and there's about six or seven of these guys chasing after them, and the car flips over, and then they're just running, and they start, and then the dad, not the dad, the son says, "Let's try to get to Grandpa's boat." So they're running to the grandpa's boat, and the jeep is chasing after them. And Frank is he when he sees the kids, when he sees the when he sees his wife and son driving away, he chases after them. Excuse me. And he goes and he goes after them, and he tries goes as quick as he can to get to them, but the wife and son are running down the pier, and they get run over. Frank Castle is very pissed, and the guys end up coming up to him. He's got a double barrel shotty. He goes and he's like, "All right, that's it," you know, and he goes and fucking pumps it. It's out, and you're like, "Oh shit!" And then They like beat him up. The other son of Howard Saint beats him up and stuff like that, throws him off of a thing, and then they light the pier on fire and it with gasoline and stuff, and he blasts gets blasted in the pier, and the Candelaria, I believe is what it's called, finds him later on and helps him, gets him back to his house and stuff, and now he's got a beard and longer hair and stuff. So he gets the guns. He moves next door to some people, and he goes and says, you know, he goes and builds his badass car that's all metal and shit. And not all metal, but it's got like metal shields type things over that go over the windows. He's got like he rigs all these different type of things. So he meets. So the next door neighbors are kind of skeptical. They're like, "What's the deal? What's up with this guy? He's he seems, you know, crazy." So they're scared of him. They think he's a murderer or something, but he's not, you know. So then they go and Frank grabs Mick. And Mick, he's got a he hangs Mick upside down. And Mick was the one who was with the Howard Saint's son who got killed. So Mick goes to Frank captures Nick, and Nick what is it? No, not Nick. Mick, he hangs Mick upside down, and he's going to torture him, and he's like, all right, so I'm going to, you know, do you know what the smell of burning flesh is, smells like or something, and he's, you know, creeping out Mick and stuff. He's like, so you're going to, first, since this is 2,000 degrees, you're not going to feel anything. You are just going to, your nerves will just die, and it'll just feel cold. So what he does is he rubs a popsicle up against Mick, freaking him out. Not right away. He tortures him, you know, really just pushes him and stuff. And then he rubs a popsicle and, you know, makes Mick get all fucking freaked out. So Mick, he gets convinces Mick to help him out. So later on, the next door neighbors, there's a big guy played by John Pinette, who's a comedian. This other guy, Dave, and then a girl. And the girl's a waitress, and they're all friends and stuff. I'm pretty sure Dave and Bumpo is Dave's friend. And they're really close friends. Dave's got three piercings right in his bottom lip. He's got an eyebrow piercing and a nose piercing. Got shaggy, a little pretty shaggy hair too. So one of the girl's ex-boyfriend's like trying to get her out and stuff. And he's like, she's scared, really scared, and she's got the door locked. He's slamming on the door. It's supposedly early in the morning. And then, what is it? The one guy, Bumpo comes out. He's like, dude, it's really late. And he's like, oh, get away. Get out of here, fat ass. And, you know, Bumpo's scared, so he's like, okay, I'm going to go over here, back over here. And then, Dave, he, like, slaps Dave around. And then Frank Castle's like, no, you know, what are you doing? Don't do that shit. So then he, like, the guy, the ex-boyfriend or boyfriend or whatever, he pulls a knife. He had a weird nickname of some sort, can't remember. But pulls a butterfly knife on him, and he's like, you know, oh, you fucking with him. He, geez, damn it, he grabs the knife, he out of his hand, punches him in the face, and then he's like, he said something to the guy, and just smacked him right in the nose, and the guy's like all, you know, upset. And then everyone, Bumpo and Dave and the girl are like, wow, you know, thanks. And then later on, they asked him if he could bring, that the boyfriend is in the house. So he gets over there, and he's like, all right, I'll be in there. And then he comes in, he's like looking around, and they're like, hey, and they're like, we want you to have dinner with us. And then, because Dave goes to the house, to the apartment space that Frank Castle's in, and Dave's like, you need to come quick, you know, the ex-boyfriend's actually in the apartment. So, you know, he gets there, and they're like, oh, we want you to eat with us. And so he eats, and they're just like, oh, yeah, this is cool. And then they're, what's it called? Oh, so Bumpo, when they're done eating and stuff, he's like, all right, so, he's like, thanks for the dinner, and he's like, wait, wait, there's dessert. You gotta try my ice Florentine. So Bumpo goes and he's making that and stuff, and Dave, he brings Dave and stuff, and then, she's, the girl's talking to him like, oh, you know, I meet, he gets up and he's like looking at the window, and she's like about to kiss him or something. He leaves. So basically Harry Saint, not Harry, Howard Saint, he hears about Bumpo, not Bumpo, about Frank Castle being alive still. So he sends, like, all right, just do whatever you can, send the Russian. So he sends the Russian, and then the Russian, just a big-ass fight, and this dude is played by Kevin Nash, the wrestler. This guy's huge. I guess he's 6'10"? Fucking crazy. But yeah, so he's just a big fucking dude, like, probably 400 pounds or something. And this is like, okay, Frank Castle's a big dude, like, he's a pretty fucking ripped. And he's got, it would be like comparing, like, Popeye and, to, like, SpongeBob or something. Or to, like, a normal character or something. Popeye when he's at spinach. And then, but then you got Frank Castle, who is fighting the Russian, and the Russian is like Popeye on spinach, and then Frank Castle is like olive oil. It's just crazy, crazy, crazy. But the Russian's like on PCP or something, because Frank like stabs him and he just takes it out, just the bloody knife, and it's like a 10-minute fight, throws Frank through walls and stuff. Frank grabs a gun, and then the Russian grabs a fucking like brick and just slams it, breaks the fucking barrel of the gun. And then he jumps in the bathroom, and then he finds a grenade, he grabs a grenade, and then he throws it out, and then closes the door. And then the Russian just, he has got like a fucking crowbar, he bats it back in, goes through the window, and Frank jumps into the fucking bathtub, and it just blows up and shit. So this is a crazy fight scene. Frank Castle is trying to take down the Saints all bit by bit. So what he's doing is he's, Quentin, Quentin Glass is the best friend of Howard Saint, and it turns out that he's a gay sadist. But yeah, he's a crazy, pretty crazy guy. But Howard goes, not Howard, Dave hides. He's hanging out with the Bumpo and Dave and the girl, and then he sees this a bunch of people coming, so like, oh, you need to hide. And so Quentin and some other guys, I believe it's the other son too, is there, and he's like, oh, you know, and Quentin's trying to kind of act friendly, you know, tricking Dave, and then he ends up torturing Dave and just ripping out one of Dave's eyebrow rings, and Dave's just like bloody, and then they have what is it, Frank Castle is he's like pissed off about this, so he wants to, you know, avenge Dave in a sense. But what he's doing is he's tricking Howard, making Howard think that his family and everyone is like tricking him and stuff, you know, blowing up other people's money that's Howard's, that the other people are giving to him and stuff like that. And later on, Frank Castle ends up in the main mansion, and then he just fucking shit up, dude. He stabs a guy right through the fucking throat, right through the jugular, upwards, right through his mouth. I don't know if it, like, pinched the bottom of his nose or the septum, but you could see the knife through his mouth right here. And then he fucking stabbed the knife to the guy's hand, like, right here. It was just, like, knife, just, you know. And then, blasted a couple dudes, even slit a guy's throat with a fucking curved blade. Curved. Can't see it. And there we go. Yeah, like that. And then, just, wow. But it's a fucking intense movie. Oh, also, in the middle of the movie, this guy, Heck, he goes and, Frank is sitting eating breakfast or something at the girl's diner, and so, you know, he's enjoying it and stuff, and then he comes in and the guy's like, he starts singing a song, and it's like, oh, it turns out to be about, you know, Frank Castle's situation. So Frank, you know, is like, what the hell? And then he's like, you know who I am, Frank? He's like, no. He's like, oh, I know who you are, you know, and I know what you've been through. And I'm going to be play this song at your funeral or something. So Frank ends up being chased by Heck, and they end up having, like, kind of a battle and stuff a little bit. And then fucking the car gets turned over by Heck, and he's all, like, beaten and stuff. And then, Howard pulls out a blade, and Heck's got a gun. He's like, you really are a fool, bringing a knife to a gunfight. And then it's a switchblade, but it's a projectile, so it just shoots out. Darkness, so he's like, you know, blitz. Yeah, crazy. So, yeah, that's part of that. And, I have never seen this movie till just today. Thanks to my friend Andy for letting me borrow it. You're fucking awesome, Andy. And just wow. He's not a vigilant. He's not, you know, you could say he's maybe like Batman type thing, but he's not just going after like just criminals. He is going after, you know, the worst, you know, the rapists, the murderers, you know. It's like, well, isn't that kind of like Batman? But this guy is just, like, full out, like, he doesn't have any fucking really any gadgets. He's just got badass guns and his wits. And that's what makes Frank Castle one of the most badass dudes. This is probably just as good for me, maybe even a little bit better than Iron Man 3, one, the original Iron Man. If you haven't seen The Punisher, go see it. It's not in theaters, it obviously came out in 2004. But it's not a movie you want to miss. It's fucking badass as all fuck. I give it like a million thumbs up. You know, take these thumbs, multiply them by like 300 million, and then just you have like a beautiful cloud. So that is the Punisher review. It's fucking amazing. It's badass. It's violent. It's action packed. There's guns. There's blood. It's not like fucking guts. Like, you know, none of that stuff. But there is blood. And it's fucking awesome. It is just fucking really awesome how he ends up taking, making Howard Saint get tricked and to killing his own people. And he, you know, Frank even gets Mick to help him out and stuff. And Mick gets the satisfaction because all the guys treat him like shit. So that's the Punisher review. It's fucking badass. It's awesome, amazing, sweet, spectacular, exuberant, exhilarating. Yes, badass. And that's the review. You're gonna be like, this is too long of a review. Well, sorry. Movies I really could get into, I can go on for a while. So that's the Punisher review. And